Hey folks, Landstryder here, and you're watching episode 31 in my Horizons playthrough. This pack's available on the Feed the Beast launcher and also on the Curse launcher. I recommend the Curse launcher, and there's something that I learned about that recently. The Curse launcher actually downloads the version of Java that the pack requires, so it doesn't matter what version of Java you have installed on your computer, it will go ahead and download the appropriate Java file for you, which is kind of cool and, well, kind of misleading at first, because I thought I had a Java 7 problem. It wasn't that. I think I might have mentioned this in a previous video. So anyway, recommend the Curse client for this pack, because if you have Java 7 and you don't want to update to Java 8, it'll go ahead and just download the Java file required to run the pack. Got a little bit of automation going on my blood order. You can see that it's pulsing, and I'm getting some blood into there. We come down here and look. We can see that I've put the ritual of the feathered knife under here, and that is controllable via this lever right here. We're going to automate this a little bit further today, I think. And I've also got my environmental controller centered right underneath the altar now again. So what I can do is I can just kind of stand around and fill up my life network. And if I look at what my life network currently is, I just updated to this to the Archmage's blood orb. You see that I have a demon blood shard and a stack of tenera. And I prefer to make this over the other ones because it's just relatively simple ingredients to make it. It's just obsidian, dirt, and sand. Relatively easy to get. Simple catalyst is you use a lot of this, and it's redstone, sugar, glowstone, and gunpowder. All these resources are easily available to me through my EE tablet up there. So I made a stack of tenebra, and I've activated this ritual over here one time. You see that I put in a demon summoning altar. I've done this in previous episodes. That's why I didn't really show too much of it, but I will go ahead and we'll summon one of these guys. It does require that you have the arcane pillith in the middle. These things are not too difficult to make. You start with the pedestal. This guy right here, the arcane pedestal, which is a bunch of obsidian. You gotta get the weak blood shards, but those are actually really easy for me to get using the farm, the wither farm over in the nether. I can get those real easy that way. I can just go over there and kill stuff with my bound blade. All I need to over there. And get lots of stuff. Now I'm gonna be using the loot master to kill this elemental. I also am carrying the Raiden flower charm, which increases mob drops. And the first time, I didn't even think about putting this amulet on. Where is it at? It's a ring. Killing mobs yields more drops. So let's try putting this on in addition to the Raiden charm and see if we can get three. Because I got two blood shards. I got two demon blood shards out of my first kill. Pretty nice. Get out from under there as soon as you start the ritual, because lots of thunder and lightning. Now the reason I have it in this shape is because I almost always use a containment ritual. You can see that since I'm using the containment ritual, it cannot get out of there. It's stuck right there. It can still hit me if I get close enough. But part of that ritual, you can see that blends in really good with this structure, that I always tend to build this something about this shape whenever I build one of these demon summoning altar thingies, rituals, whatever you want to call it. Then I combine it with the containment ritual so that whatever I summon is pretty much prone and can't really move or get away or come at me. Did I kill it? I killed it. How many did I get? I did. I got three demon blood shards from that guy. So yeah, they do stack. So wow, I bet I could get three or four wither stars at a time from killing the wither and such. So very, very nice interaction there Go ahead and put that back on. And put the other ring away. And let's talk about some of the other things that I've made off camera between this episode and last. And that is, I went ahead and crafted the Amulet of Sacrifice. Okay, so I learned that the other amulet that I made last time, the Amulet of Self-Sacrifice, only works if I personally die. Which, I didn't want to use that. I want to use the Amulet of Sacrifice. So whenever I kill a mob, it stores some LP. And I believe, I'm not sure how I get it back out of there. I think there's a, I don't know if I put it in here. What's it do? Yeah, okay, there we go. I can just click it. And no, actually, that's just filling up by itself. Oh, it did. It did take the life out of the Amulet of Sacrifice and put it into the Blood Otter. Very nice. Cool. So that's how that works. We'll put that back in there and we'll continue to fill that up as I'm around here. So I already used one, like I said, I already used one Demon Blood Shard to make my Archmage. Archmage's Blood Orb. So we're up to that point. So I'm up to tier 5, altar, tier 5, orb, we're good there. Now I have only this really simple automation that I put so that I would be able to throw stacks of stone into the altar at a time. We're going to replace that with a more, with the Sangomancy automation. But before we do that even, I need to just tell you about this thing right here, the Glass Sacrificial Orb. You can see that I have a shard of glass. The way that you get the shards of glass, let me head up to the base here real quick. Give me my wind charm. I'm gonna head up to the base real quick, and let's see here. You get some glass. And you take that, let me get a couple of them. You know, it's not 100% chance. You get some flint. Well, flint. Lay down your glass, or lay out your glass. And then you break it with a flint. And there you go. Occasionally you will get glass shards. You can make armor out of these. There's some different usages for them. You can make armor. You can make this glass sacrificial orb. You can make the glass dagger of sacrifice and glass armor out of it. This apparently doesn't have a whole lot of protection or endurance. But what it will do is anything that does hit you will start to bleed, and it will die from bleeding most likely. But this thing right here, the Glass Sacrificial Orb, will allow you to get a little bit more than twice what a standard sacrificial orb will grant you at the Blood Altar. Now, the problem is it will occasionally cause blindness and bleeding. So there is some danger in using it, but if you've got the that environmental controller with the Regeneration 3, works pretty good. So remember, my altar was giving me just under 2,000. It was like 1,875 blood every time I used the sacrificial orb, the regular one. When I use the glass sacrificial orb, I get 4,700 blood into the altar with that. So really nice. Really nice way to be able to increase the amount of blood that you get in there. Makes it easier to do some of the larger infusions, especially if you don't have enough if you don't have enough storage in your altar to hold it all in there, and you have to fill it and keep it filled for a big thing. So I guess the server will be back soon. I'm not sure. I think that's Dornell sending me a message. So anyway, let's continue on here. So that's that. That was something very good from Blood Arsenal. Some other things you can do with the Blood Arsenal. Blood Arsenal allows you to shrink your rituals. And you do that by crafting this thing right here, the Soul Compactor. And you would place that Soul Compactor underneath the Master Ritual Stone and click it with your Blood Orb. I think it's your Blood Orb. Either your Blood Orb or your your activation crystal. One of those. It takes quite a lot of life points to compact the ritual, and you'll get it, basically the ritual, all shrunk down into one block. Not going to be doing that today, but I did want to just explain it real quick. I haven't come up with a really good reason to do that, because I kind of actually like the rituals in their full size, fully expanded version. So what I am going to want to do is possibly make some of these other sigils. I'm not sure how all these work. Obviously, lightning makes lightning and different things. It has different modes. There's also one other blood magic add-on in this that I wasn't thinking about last time. It's called Sanguine Utilities, which adds a few extra sigils. I think it might add some extra rituals too. So sigil building, I would assume, works similar to a wand of our builder's wand. And then the sigil of destruction, I'm definitely going to want to probably try one of these out. It basically says you can get up to a 64 long, actually I think you get longer than that, you get to down the 256 long tunnel, apparently, created with one of these things. So that might be cool. I can also probably make a spell that would do something similar. But the sanguomancy adds something called corruption and allows you to have there's a soul dimension, soul network dimension, what's it called? Soul chunk claimer. We need to go over it there in order to be able to use the soul chunk claimer. Remember, way back in the first episode, we started one of those. I'm going to try to get to that today real quick too. So first thing I need to do is I want to automate my altar. And for that, I need this thing right here. The altar manipulator requires 4 of these altar emitters and 4 of these altar diviners. The altar diviner is to take a blood altar and put it into the altar and it will convert. So I've gone ahead and I've taught this to make the altars, because I think I'm going to need quite a few of them. I thought I did. How about blood? I could have swore that I taught this thing how to make blood altars. Okay, maybe didn't learn it. So let's let me double check, make sure it actually still has an E value. It does, has exchange value. That's the recipe. Maybe it just didn't take. We'll go ahead and make another one. Gonna need a furnace. And then hopefully I have everything else in the table for this. No diamonds. Out of diamonds in there. I'll get a few of those. Now, can I make one of these? There we go. Blood altar. I definitely have enough I definitely have enough E in there to make it. So I'm gonna go ahead and try to teach this thing to it again. Cause I swear that I did this earlier, but sometimes it doesn't seem to want to take it. So I took it that time. Hopefully now when I search in here, there we go. Blood altars. Give me a bunch of those. I got a stack of them. There we go. That'll work. Toss those back. Okay, so I really don't need these glass shards right now. This is the only thing I really wanted to make out of that glass shard for myself. And I'll just put the rest of those in there for now. And put that away. I was using the chisel to do all that work on the demon summoning altar earlier. This is definitely... definitely like the way this one looks this time. Probably one of the better ones I've done as far as texture choosing. Especially like the energized void stone columns. I think those look nice. A lot of the energized void stone textures are kind of broken, but these ones worked, so I like that. And these ones are technically broken, but I kind of like the way they look for these little pillars. So anyway. Let's go put one of these blood altars in the blood altar. And that sounds kind of like Inception. All right, blood altar in the blood altar. Okay, that came out. That went through fast. Get another one. We're going to need four of these. Now, the altar diviner, place adjacent to the altar. I guess we could actually play with this. How does this work? So if I do that, put stuff in there, what's it do?
Sorry.
Now, you can read about all these different things. Sanguomancy is pretty well documented. Where is that? There it is. Divining in the darkness. You start with one of these books. Delving into the darkness. Sorry, not divining. Delving into the darkness. You start with one of these books. And it has four general categories. This one tells you about the mechanics of the mod. So soul corruption and such. This is, tells you about the rituals added by this mod. The items added by this mod, and finally the blocks, and that's where we're going to find the altar diviner. Second stage is a GUI-less machine with a single internal slot. Items are placed into it via right-clicking. Empty hand must be used to empty it. What makes this block special is the fact that it integrates integral content will be transferred to the blood altar only if it contains enough life essence. It can move up to a stack of items at a time. To work correctly, this block needs to be placed adjacent to the blood altar. Okay, so that's why it's not putting anything in there right now, because it's trying to put that whole stack in there, and it's never gonna have enough stuff in there in order to put stuff in there. So if I do that, see, it automatically put the thing in there, and then it pulled it out. Very nice. Pulls it back out. I don't know if this can be piped into. I think it's not meant to be piped into. Let's see. Maybe, do I have a hopper? A couple hoppers would be nice, just to kind of play and experiment with. So let's come back up here and grab a hopper. Or two. And I've got some that pipe stuff down there too. And possibly work if I need to. Okay, so if I can't even attach a hopper to this. Oh, there we go. Okay, then I can attach a hopper to it. If I throw these in there, will it hop? Yeah, it did. Hopper that baby right in there. Okay, it's hoppering. Now it's like it's not going to put any more in there because it doesn't have enough blood. Okay, so pull those back out of there. Gonna end up with a couple of these, probably more than any. Let me just yerk those out of there. Oh, wait. Okay, come on. Give me those. Okay, there we go. Okay, I only need one more. So yeah, you could definitely work with this if you set up some kind of, you could set some automation up with this for sure. But there's generally how that works. We're going to kind of skip that stage of the automation of that. Although I kind of like the fact that it goes beside it. Goes beside the altar. And does this thing. And it won't put nothing into the altar. I kind of wonder if you put one on one side and one on another side. So if I put one on that side and I put one on that side, is that going to confuse it? Let me go get something to experiment with this. Let me get some stone here. It's the last of the stone I had over there. I have to make some more with the tablet later. Okay, and if I put one stone in there. Oh, that was weird. Okay, I only put one stone in there. What happened? That is weird. Is there something actually in there? No. Okay, so this is not an advisable thing to do here. Obviously, it's flipping out. There's really nothing in this one, I don't think. No. Yeah, see, it was a ghost. Okay, so not advisable. Definitely will misbehave. But we know. Now we know. Okay, so the other thing I need is alter emitters, which is a bunch of redstone, blocks of redstone, levers. Okay, so back up here to craft some things. Grab a stack of that. I only got one stick in here. We will have more sticks soon enough. Get some sticks. More sticks. Sticks and stones will make levers. You know that saying, right? I need four of them at least. Everybody knows that old saying, right? And I already got some those in there. One, two, three, four of those. Nice. Okay, so next up is to put these together using my orb. Was it like that, or was it the other way? It was like that. Okay. Moving around the corners, and that gives me the altar manipulator. This is the tier 3 version of automation from Sangomancy. And we'll take a quick read on that. The Altar Manipulator, like its predecessor's GUI-less machine, however, it has more complex than others, where the Altimeter and the Altar Diviner were somehow limited. The Altar Manipulator has no such qualms. Indeed, any item inserted into it can be taken from the block, cannot be done by human hands. Basically, that means you got to do it using automation, either pipes or with hoppers. So let's head back down there. And the altar manipulator goes directly on top of the altar. Right? Yes, goes right there like that. And like I said, like it says, I can't place nothing into it like that. What I need to do is I need to hopper it in. So if I hopper those stones into there. Not sure what it's doing. Hard to tell what it's doing. It's putting stone in there, yeah. Gonna be doing things, I guess. Got stone in the altar and stone in it. Kind of curious how this is gonna work. I'm picturing a system using some refined relocation and some keep item stocked upgrades to some of the relocators and such, possibly. Interesting. Okay, so it pulled some stuff out and then it put some other stone in. Okay, so now it's got stuff to be pulled out. Okay, so let's bust this chest right here real quick and get that back, and we will do one of these. We will attach this to this side and put our chest right here, and that will allow us to pull things out. Yeah, I need the configurator. There we go. That should pull stuff out. Doesn't seem to want to pull stuff out right there. Set to pull. Not pulling anything. Interesting. Now can I get it out of my hand? No. Cannot do that. Okay, so it doesn't like the idea of having stuff pulled out the side? I'm not sure. Yeah, let's see if we can read a little bit about it. We'll then pick up the items once the item is crafted and done. Hold it until it is taken out. This makes sure that the item inserted is processed only once, and not until it has reached its maximum. Okay, so. Right, so why is this not pulling out, though? Obviously, it does not like the mechanism pipe, apparently. Yeah, oh wait, no. There's blank slates in there. There's 33 blank slates in there. Oh, so that's a glitch. That's a glitch. So if I go ahead and throw those back into there, it's going to be getting blank slates in, putting them down into there. Well, let me see. I should show up some of those advanced ones here in a little bit. Shortly. In just a second. Okay, so there's some visual glitches going on, but it is working the way it's supposed to. So there we go. I've more automated it. I was kind of automated. It wasn't really automated before. This is actually automated. I'm going to throw a bunch of stone in here or whatever. Actually, it's not taking anything in there. It's not accepting any more right now, apparently. Still got 23 in there. Okay, well, there we go. It did actually take them in and push them through at the end. So there we go. That is automated. Good. Okay. The only other thing I wanted to do was to actually make one of these altar emitters and use that to toggle my... things down here. I want to toggle both of these. I can use some project or blue power logic and wire. I'll make all these different kinds of bluestone wire and run that down and attach that to the ritual stone there to turn it off and on. And I can also turn off and on the environmental controller at the same time using that same thing. I'm going to set that logic up off camera. I'll just show it to you next episode. I think I'm pretty much done with the automation of this for now. Messing with this, showing it to you. I think it works pretty good. I can make demons. I can get bunches of demon blood shards. I might make myself a set of bound armor. I've done that many times on camera before, so I'm not going to show that. I'll just go over whatever I decide to do with it if I do make it. Although I'm pretty freaking happy with my clockwork armor. It's been very good to me. It's very, very good protection. So I might just stick with it. And finally, the last thing I want to do is get over to that soul chunk stuff in Sanguomancy. And that's kind of expensive to do. You start with a soul chunk claimer. It would be kind of expensive to make one otherwise. You need a corrupted demon shard and some demonic slates. But since we started with these, I think they're actually in one of our modular tablets here. Yeah, there they are, the three. One for me, one for Dornell, and one of Raccoons is there. So we've got the soul transporter right here is what we need to get over to the... that dimension and claim our soul chunk. So for that we're going to need a demonic slate and a sigil of Ender Surveillance. That's not too bad. Well, I need another demonic slate. I actually got one demonic slate in my inventory. If I go ahead and put one of those in there and let that go ahead and process, that should process. Looks like it did. Imbued. I'm going to need two of these total. What was the other thing? Divination Sigil, Demonic Slate, the Ender. Okay, cool. I think I have all that. That shouldn't be too difficult. Okay, so there's the two Demonic Slates I'm going to need total. And finally, need some Soul Sand and two filled sockets. Okay, so I need some sockets. And those are also what you use to create your blood armor. So, sockets, let's see here. It'd be really nice if this had an EE value. It does not, dang. because it uses those shards. And I need glass and diamonds. And I should have most of that. Hopefully I have enough shards in here. How many do I have? 7. Seriously, I'm short like one shard, looks like. Let's pull that out of there. I got glass. No diamonds? No diamonds in my inventory. Yeah, that's right. I threw them back into the thing. Diamonds. Ooh, I don't have enough EE right now. Okay, so let's put some of these back. And I'm going to probably end up having to go over to one. Yep, I gotta go over to farm a few mobs real quick to get me all those last couple there, that last blood shard. Alright. Turn that on. We'll get this out. Now whenever I need to like put a filter on this thing because that you just go in there. It's oh yeah. There's my blood shard. A couple of them. Real easy way to get them since these guys have a good amount of hit points. They take more than one hit. Which is necessary when you're trying to get blood shards. I'm trying to back off, right? Yeah. By the way, using the AoE with the bound blade does not give you more blood shards. I already tested that. So it's definitely best if you're going for blood shards, you kill them one at a time. Otherwise, you're not going to get what you're looking for. Okay. And let's throw something in there so I can pick up this. There we go. Pick up that. I need to take those out of there. Kind of want those. Throw that there. And I really don't care about the rest of that stuff. Okay. Just put that down, and then it'll empty out. Got a little bit of diamonds there. Alright, back over. Let's make the other socket, get it filled, get this thing made, get over there and claim my soul chunk. Because I think that's... And then once I get to that point, we're probably going to wrap it up. Alright. Back up there with Wind Charm. What can I dump into here? At least I can get rid of those heads, and should have everything to make the second one of those. Good. All right. Now that I got that altar nicely automated, I can just go down and throw these in to the hopper, and should just automatically process them. Maybe. I don't want to take either of those in. That could be because it takes 30,000. See, that's one of the disadvantages of this little system, is unless you have a whole lot of capacity upgrades, the stuff's not going to go in there. It won't even accept it. It won't even think about taking it because the altar doesn't have enough capacity to register that it's even possible. You can still just manually put things in, and then we'll pull it out when it's done. That's nice. There's at least that. It's one of those times that I might want to use this thing. Give myself some extra blood in there. And you can see it gave me blindness and bleeding there for just a second. There we go. And let me deactivate that blind blade before it runs my blood network out all the way. Okay, so that should be everything we need to make this... thing. And I'm really, really, really really hoping that my charged porter will bring me back from that dimension. Otherwise, you would need to make two of these things. One to go over and one to get back. And they're kind of expensive. Soul transporters. Oh, I need soul sand. So back up to the base. Some soul sand out of here. Two, three. Yeah, do I have everything that it takes? Nope, I still gotta make the Ender Sigil, which is Ender Eyes and Ender. Two, three, four of those, and drop something up into there I'm not using right now. One, two of those. Yeah, that's not gonna work. Would have been nice. So was it these there? Was in that last spot? One of these blood shards, wasn't it? Yeah, there we go. Okay, so that goes there. That goes there. Divination. These were here, like so. There we go. Soul transferred on. It burns all that stuff up. I was afraid of that. Okay, well. Let's drop off a couple things I don't need. Don't really need that. That actually doesn't seem to want to use the blocks of redstone. That. Those actually had a drawer, but it lost it because then I took them all out. They go there. There we go. Shouldn't need those. Shouldn't need these right now. See, this can go back in here. Just clean my inventory up a bit. I actually got a tab for magic stuff. We'll just throw all the rest of the magic related stuff into here for now. Ritual stones, hoppers can probably get broke down. Alright, we're fairly cleaned up here. Throw those hoppers in there. Oh. And those that I don't need right now. Okay, cool. Alright, well, here we go. Let's go take... Oh. Before we go over there, just in case I can't connect to this from over there, go ahead and get my soul chunk claimer out. Alright, let's go. Alright, that was easy. Pretty straightforward. And lots of blood bricks and slimes and interesting. You can see that I'm down at Y level 4, so there's nothing probably underneath this. Look at all the slimes. Well, if you need slime, you know where to get it. I wonder if mobs are like probably not supposed to spawn over here. I don't know. Guessing. I'm pretty sure that those bushes are not supposed to spawn over here either. We've got all kinds of probably berry bushes on various bushes. And dungeons. Oh, we got dungeons over here. From Essential Craft. Look at that. This is Essential Craft dungeon right over here. Of some sort. Ooh, it's got some nasty corruption going on. Anything interesting in there? Wind effects or elemental buckets? Oh, some extra rations. Not always not bad. Very interesting. Yeah, it's totally not supposed to, I'm pretty sure these are not supposed to spawn over here. So, for all you mod pack makers out there, you'll want to do something to prevent this if you don't want it to happen. Anyway, let's look at our soul chunk. Let's look at our chunk lines here. We're going to claim a chunk. We want to claim the chunk right beside the... we'll just do this nice empty chunk right here. So I don't got to pick anything up or clean anything out. Oop. My goodness. Oh, so many slimes. They should just, you should just call this the slime dimension instead of the soul chunk dimension. I'm gonna have to razz him. I've actually played on a server with Tobin before, and he's the author of this mod. And, he's a cool dude. But I am gonna have to give him, I'm gonna have to see if I can't contact him and give him a little bit of a hassle about that. Alright, let's claim our soul chunk. Shazam! Okay, cool. Chunk something something Z percentage Z. Z percentage in dimension. Percentage S was claimed. Whoa! Oh, that's the in-game wiki. I don't want to mess with that. That'll crash me. What I wanted to do was open this up. So, this is my soul. This is where my soul chunk is at. Okay, can I do that? No. Can I... I need to make something to mark this. Because I need to be kind. I guess I need to come back to this area at some point. To and from here. Look at that. There's gas from Gascraft. This might be a good place to find that stuff. Find oil. You're supposed to have the representations of things that you bind here. I don't know how that's going to work out. I should have brought a sign or something, just something. Well, actually, let me make sure. Okay, I can get into here. So since I can get into here, what I'm going to do is grab out some kind of block. Those and those. And I'm going to give myself some pillars on the outside corners of my soul chunk. Just so I can remember where it's at. Like so. So, now when I bind stuff, like... Well, it's nighttime over here now, so now we got all the regular mobs coming out, too. Let me check something here. Do I still... I do. Like that. How about if I put that there? Ha! That'll help. That'll help out. That should keep it. Keep me from being hassled in the future, anyway. I don't do anything for the ones that are currently spawned, but... I'm gonna make some more of those, because I really like using them. I like having one on me so that if I need an area to be less hostile, I can just throw it down. Okay, so turn off. So I should have... Now that I've claimed it, I think I have to rebind my blade. Where'd it go? Right? Like if I pull this out right now and... Yeah, it didn't like make anything over here. Okay, so now I think if I go ahead and bind something new to me, like a new kind of bound tool or something like that, or I create a ritual from this point on, I should be getting things over here in my soul network. But yeah, I wanted to show that later in a future episode. Next episode, I think I'm going to get into a new tech mod that I haven't really messed with, and we're going to take a look at quantum stuff. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it. Be sure and leave a like and a comment and a thumbs up if you did. Until next time, I will catch you later.